Johnny Cox.
Right, this is the questions and answers time of the show.
Right.
So anyway, here's the first one. Kinky Afro.
What about it?
What advice would you give to anyone turning 30 this year?
Oh, God. You know, when I wrote that, I was about 24, but Sonny, I'm 24. He only went with your mother because she's a fucking whore, didn't fit. What would I give anyone who's advice to 30? Oh, you still got another few years at it, yeah.
Don't actually start till you get to 50.
40, 50, 60. You know, 30's a new 40, 40's a new fucking whatever, and 50's a new 40, and 60's a new fucking 21.
But 30 is your youngest foot, man, and just
absolutely, baby. Yeah. I mean, men especially, not women, but men are still teenage boys at 30. Easy.
Yeah. But I thought it was really
even if you're running a fucking company, you're still a fucking child if you're a man at 30.
Anyway, so enough of that. you know what, though? You've answered the next question.
Go on, hit me with it, baby.
Yeah, no, you've already answered it, mate.
What was it?
You know, because as always, you've got far too much to say for yourself.
Yeah, go on.
And the next question was, how many lines in Kinky Afro were true? And, none of it was true.
I mean, about the songs, right, they're a mixture of everything. I mean, my songs, right, it could be, you know, I've got one line for me and you going out, getting pissed, taking drugs and being on the pull. Then I've got another line of what I've just watched on fucking on the news. I've got another line of what you just said to me. And then what you do is you get all these great lines and then you put them all down and like a fucking puzzle, you put them together to make something that makes sense. Yeah. And that's how I work on songwriting. I write comic strip cartoon songs.
A collective collection of life experiences.
Eclectic collection of life experiences.
I can't believe I just managed to say that without...
Fucking hell, neither can I. Well,
this is a weird question, right? Do you find it... This is like... I didn't ask you this, though.
Go on.
And I've never
is
ever...
this one of them... You know, if I say it wrong, I could be in trouble for fucking up the youth.
I don't actually find it, but I think you look good in lycra, but I don't care what anyone else. It says there, do you find it embarrassing that Shaun is now a mammal?
A mammal?
A middle-aged man in lycra.
I don't wear lycra. Well, when I go cycling, right, I get on waterproofs or jeans and a fucking, you know, fully waterproof fucking Gore-Tex. So I don't wear lycra.
Yes, so that's an official denial of ever wearing
lycra. I am an official denial that I do lycra. Yeah, because I don't even, you know, that tight fit and all that, like, I can't fucking do it. Well, I like a loose fit.
It's got to be a loose fit.
Yeah, you know what I mean? I mean, all that fucking tight gear, you know. I mean, how many fucking grown men look like fucking penguins in them? You know what I mean? Once you get fucking even 38, you can't be in skinny jeans. Fuck What's me. That?
And this next question, if I was a fucking journalist, I'd be embarrassed asking this question. But anyway, here it is.
Can you imagine me? I got a job as a journalist once.
Well,
no, for the Daily Sport, maybe I was a pornographer or a journalist. I don't quite remember. But I did, and I'm dyslexic, dysfunctional.
Well, we once did Penthouse. That was a great journalist.
We did Penthouse, didn't we? Yeah.
With Miss Whiplash and what she was called.
Lindsay Drew.
Yeah, it's every boy's dreams to end
up. Of course it is.
But that's your, like, you know what I mean?
In Penthouse.
Yeah.
With me Comme des Garçons blazer on, I had on that jacket.
Yeah, you look
and then
really
we got in the bath. I look about 12, mate.
You look like Elton John at this time with that jacket on.
A 12-year-old Elton John.
Yeah.
Have you seen them photos? We look like fucking babies, mate.
Yeah. Well, life's not being kind to us, has it? This is a questionnaire from Phil Shotton.
Phil, director of all our videos.
Yeah. And it's a tricky one.
Go on, it's tricky.
Tricky. You might not know the answer.
Is it in the 90s?
Yeah. Do you have any recollection of making the Step On video?
Do I have any recollection of making the Step On? Recognition, is it?
Did I say it wrong,
You're using fucking big words, mate. Can I remember it?
It's because I'm playing the role
I can actually remember that. Don't you remember that tour? We sat every fucking gig around Europe. I mean, the coach driver was an ex-fucking dude, wasn't it? And we was only young lads, and we was like having a joke with him, but he couldn't take jokes.
You know what, though?
So he tried to kill us.
I think we was at our wildest. We got made to believe through social engineering.
That was great.
That is the way to behave as a rock and roller.
Yeah.
We only done what was expected of us.
What was done before, what you did in a jazzy.
What
them rock and rollers in the 40s did. We were just doing what, you know, we were being all jazzy.
And because we didn't know better.
We didn't know better.
We had it.
Had no better. Uneducated. Salford lads, didn't know better.
What other excuse can we throw in? It wasn't me, Your Honour. It wasn't our fault.
No, definitely wasn't our fault. It was the bloody pushers. We filmed it on top of an hotel.
In Sitges,
the gay capital of Spain.
And
what a fucking place that was. It was a bang-on fucking place, mate. It was like straight out of a gay porn film. It was fucking... It was an happening place.
We made the video there,
and...
It looked like we made it in sunny California or somewhere like
it
that.
Did.
Everyone thought...
Everyone thought we made it in LA because actually, it was in the 90s, you know, early 90s, it was shown constantly on MTV in the States. And that opening shot with the palm trees, about 2 years later, that's the opening shot of the fucking first Bad Boys movie.
Was it?
Exactly a similar opening shot.
But in LA.
So he must have seen it.
Well, if anyone out there fancies asking us any question, we don't care. We've got no skeletons, have we?
No. We don't care. Plenty of fucking skeletons, mate.
send your questions to the link below, and we'll get them all answered to you.
Hope you like what you see.
Subscribe.
Subscribe and what?
Like.
Subscribe and like.
Yeah.